Hey, welcome back. I hope you all enjoyed the Halloween special. I know I had a lot of fun doing all of this. If you haven't seen it yet, make sure you go check out the video. But I know that what all you nerds want to know is, how does all of this actually work? Well, let me tell you, it's actually pretty cool, and there's a lot more to it than it may seem on the surface. So, let's go check it out. So the main attraction, rightfully so, is the 833A vacuum tube Tesla coil, which you can see in one of the previous videos. The main difference here, however, is it's controlled remotely by an Arduino connected to this power relay that I can use to turn the coil on and off. Get more into that here in a little bit. Of course, also we have the Frankenstein-inspired subject table with the quote-unquote dead body that we're trying to bring to life. And this is actuated. There's a linear actuator here that's controlled by yet another Arduino. Then, of course, to give us some atmosphere, we've got LED lights on the window, we've got lights up in the ceiling, and we've got lights down along the floor. Mad Scientist classic, of course, is the Jacob's Ladder. This is a 15,000 volt, 60 milliamp neon sign transformer, which is what I use to power the Tesla coil when it's in the spark gap configuration, actually. Then, of course, we've got that really annoying spark that keeps going off randomly in the background. That's made by our flyback transformer here, connected to some high-voltage capacitors to make the arc a bit nastier. And that's turned on and off randomly to make a spark between that spark gap, which, you guessed it, again, is controlled by another Arduino. There's something about old CRT displays showing some really creepy stuff that just screams sci-fi mad scientist to me. So we have this old CRT monitor that I have that actually works that prints off some spooky little info. This is actually controlled by, if I can find it in here, first generation Raspberry Pi that I've had sitting around because I remembered, oh yeah, these things have a composite video output on them, so I can use that for something. And so that just runs a little script that I made here to display some spooky looking stuff on the screen. And at the beginning of the video, we have the oscilloscope displaying a signal. Now this signal actually comes from the CRT monitor. Just not even directly connected to anything. I just wrapped a loose open-ended wire around the edge of the monitor there, and you actually get a pretty interesting little signal off of that. Then, of course, we have the finale of the video, which was the dual resonant microwave oven transformer setup. Just stuck these on here, turned them on, and arced them with the big stick, and you get quite an impressive show from that. So I don't know if you noticed, but if you listened carefully, when I started the reactor in the video, we had a sound effect that turned on that was the sound of the reactor. That was actually this blower motor that I think came out of a hot water heater at one point. And again, that's triggered by another Arduino and a relay. I was going to use that motor, but it wasn't really loud enough. I was just lazy and I didn't take it away from here when I decided to switch to this one instead. And, of course, we've got a few other little details, like this plasma globe here that I've had for forever. Makes a nice background prop. And Mr. Skull over here has a little light bulb put inside of him, so he lights up, and it's powered by that ATX computer power supply that he's sitting on top of. And then what really brings it all together in the end is the laboratory status display and the laboratory control touchscreen panel, both of which are driven by Raspberry Pi 4s. The one Raspberry Pi that drives the display and the audio connected to the stereo system here is in there. And there's another Raspberry Pi 4 inside of the touchscreen here. The software for this is all written in Python. It's based on a library called the RPI LCARS library that was started by Toby Kurian, probably mispronouncing the name, but I'll provide the link in the description for that. But that was the starting point for this, and it's been heavily modified to do what I want, but this is what controls all the systems in the setup here. Now, this is what I think is the really cool part. Remember all those Arduinos before that I said are controlling everything, like the Tesla coil and the lights and raising and lowering the subject table and all of that? Well, all of those are connected to a Wi-Fi network. So are these two Raspberry Pis. All of the commands to command everything are sent from this touchscreen here. So when I tell the laboratory to turn on...
Laboratory systems online. Condition nominal. Standing by.
That tells the lights to turn on to the first mode, that turns on a few other things, and we're ready to go. Then I can say, alright, we want to start the whole thing, we'll just do the reactor warm-up sequence.
Reactor startup sequence commencing. Preparing for subject energy transfer.
And so while I was doing that, I probably would have raised or lowered the subject table. Then we're going to wait for that to finish. Wait for it.
Reactor startup sequence complete. Standing by to engage subject energy transfer.
Alright, so we're ready to go, and it's like, alright, we're gonna do this, I'm gonna accomplish my life's work, we're gonna resurrect Tesla, we're gonna do it, and everything's gonna be great, and...
Malfunction detected.
Oh no.
Unable to perform automated energy
transfer.
This
is a malfunction. The automated system to bring it back to life isn't gonna work. Damn those technicians. So... It's like, all right, it's fine. I can do it myself. There's a manual override mode that we can go into to do the energy transfer into the body. But you have to, you know, override the safeties. The manual override just isn't something anybody can do, right? So if you tried to engage it first, it's going to say, nope, you're not allowed to do that. So we've got our little very high-tech security safety override sequence here that we go through that. And then we say, manual.
Warning.
Uh-oh.
Safety interlocks overridden.
Here we go.
Manual energy transfer commencing in 5, 4, 3, 2, 1.
And then Tesla coil. And then after that, I'd be like, all right, here we go, we're gonna do it. I put my gloves and my goggles on, get the microwave oven transformer setup turned on, and then boom. We're sending a huge arc into the body. But yeah, that's how it works. It's all automated from this. There's not another person behind the scenes flipping switches, turning things on and off. This is a fully automated system that's all running from controls on this here. Remember what I said before? We don't do fake on this channel. Everything you saw in this video is 100% real. Well, except for the body. I guess I'm not allowed to have dead bodies and try to bring them back to life yet. We're working on that. But other than that, every effect, everything you saw here is 100% real. So even with all that, we still don't yet quite have a proper mad scientist video. First, you gotta get the ambiance right. Then, of course, you've got to dress the part. And then add just a little bit of spooky sci-fi background noise. And then, finally, no mad scientist laboratory sci-fi depiction would be complete without the fog machine. That's how we made the Halloween video. It was a lot of work that went into this, but it was a lot of fun. Hope you all enjoyed it, and I hope you enjoyed this little walkthrough explanation of how it all works. Anyway, I'll see you guys next time.
Laboratory systems offline.